Let's talk about sleep paralysis. Most people have misconceptions about sleep paralysis, many believing that demons are watching you in your sleep or holding you down in your sleep. That couldn't be further from the truth. You must understand that your soul travels every time you go to sleep. It is not dreaming, it's just your soul traveling. It's your soul entering back into your body that is still asleep. So with that being understood, you must understand that you have to also enter back into this body if you were exiting it. That's basic physics. That's how anything works. After re-entering your body, after you have traveled realities, what we know as dreaming, your body can still be asleep while your conscious and soul is inside your body. Meaning that your body is still asleep, but you are awake within your body, leaving you stuck in a sleep paralysis state.
So I ate a mango once, and it was so sweet and delicious, I wanted to keep it. So I cracked open the outer shell to get to the seed and peeled back the brown layer. I sprayed some water on a paper towel and put the seed in between, put it in a Ziploc bag, left it in my windowsill for about 2 weeks, and this crazy root grew. So I got some fresh potting soil and placed it in. I kept it in a sunny place, and after a couple weeks, I had a mango plant.
I know we all think of like third dimension, blah, 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 blah. Let's think deeper. You ever played Pac-Man? Pretty sure you have. Pac-Man never looks up. Why? Because he's in the third dimension. So all Pac-Man did was this. That's all he did. He went straight. He went back. He went left. He went right. Now, when you on 3D, that's how you live. You wake up. You look left. You go left. You go right. You go forward. You go backwards. But very rarely do you do this. You don't hear me though.
So that nigga unspiritual, all that nigga do is laugh. That nigga third eye closed and he stuck in his past. He don't even know he in the fucking matrix. If he don't tap into the soul, then somebody gon' take it.
Niggas running from their problems, boy, you gotta face it. Shadow work is mandatory, you cannot escape it. Just go within and find yourself and do some meditation. I manifested my whole life just by being patient.
Fluoride in the faucet water, so I'm drinking Sprint. Labradorite crystal on me, man, you know I'm doing my thing. Niggas on the 3D realm, all they can do is think. I got three eyes, nigga, my third one don't even blink.
My third eye don't even blink, it just sees. Seeing right through the lies, see me living on my dream. Getting angel numbers, better figure out just what it means. Going right over your head, don't understand because you sleep.
When I say I'm protected, I ain't talking about a gun. But if a nigga play stupid, then you know I got one. The system fucked up, we all know that for a fact. Free Rashad Jamal, we gotta bring the real ones
man,
back.
Free the guy Rashad, man, he innocent. I really can't stand this fucking matrix that we live in. If you a chosen one, just understand you really different, man. Focus on yourself, ain't got no time trying to be fitting in.
All doing is just I'm was flat out saying like we are gods and goddesses, because I'm more militant. That's my purpose here. His purpose, he was for herbalistic healing and to bring awakening to us on that level in a different way. So he's saying the same thing, but he's saying it more politely. Hey, you're electrical being, you need electrical foods for the body. He ain't gotta tell you what it's gonna do to your body, because once your ass start eating out of electricity, you're gonna see what you are. That's how he went about it. Whereas me, I'm more like, fuck that, this what y'all is. But it's the same message. Everything he talked about, I support. Because that's what you are. You're supposed to eat electrical stuff like fruits and vegetables. We only have, none of our teeth has canines. We only got 4 canines. Your teeth is not designed to eat meat. If it was, you would have a mouthful of canines. You don't have a mouthful of canines, nigga. We made no mistakes when we designed these avatars. Look at the shark's mouth, full of canines. Look at a lion mouth, full of canines. Now look at your mouth. You got 4 canines and all them flat teeth in your mouth. You're supposed to be eating vegetation, fruits. That's all electrical. Because you are electricity. But if you put meat into you, that's dead energy. So they fed us, they trained us to eat meat. Even me. So we ate all this meat and it deadened our energy. keep you dead. You can't even vibrate. You can't even tell. You can't teleport. You can't tap into nothing about yourself because, like they say, you are what you eat. So if we want you dead, we'll feed you dead flesh. The oppressor want us dead, so he fed us dead flesh. You get it? He don't feed you live catch. He kills it first. He tortures it. So the torture and the agony is in the blood of that animal that the oppressor has killed and hunted down. Remember, that animal was scared, ran for his life before it was killed. All of that is in the blood. No different than the adrenochrome. That's why the elites, they like to scare the kids before they kill them, because then all that adrenochrome get the flowing adrenaline, and it's more, it gives them the nutrients they need. It's the same thing when they kill cats before they give it to us. They torture it first, chase it, hunt it down, then kill it. Think about how they do the cow. That's the mind fuck of the century. They got the cow all on the farm. They feeding the cow grass. Getting the cow out to trust them and shit. The cow that grew up on the farm. He come out, eat grass every day. He trust the farmer. He grew a real relationship with the farmer, right? They just mind fucking the cow. The whole time they know they're going to kill the cow eventually. Why mind fucking though? Why build a relationship with the cow? Why go out there and milk her? Why go out there and feed her grass? Why make that cow feel like you love that cow? When you really know you set it up to kill it the whole time. The cow eating the grass thinking, oh, I'm eating all this grass because my owner loves me. The cow don't know you eating all this grass because the owner plumping you up to kill your ass. And then he plump it up. They go in there. They kill the cow. The cow all depressed. The cow all hurt. You know what I'm saying? The cow all scared, and then we turn around and we eat all the beef patties. So we putting that, not only is we putting dead energy into us, we putting all the feelings and emotions that's in the blood. That don't leave, that soaks into the flesh. The flesh is what we eat in. This shit is deep, what they have done to us. Okay? So this is why Dr. Sebi was like, man, you gotta...
Understand and discernment, all right? Understand and overstand. There's a lot of information going around this motherfucker. Why? It's the age of Aquarius. It's the age of truth, all right? And I understand that people are waking up by the masses every single day, and they need God, some type of guidance, goddamn. So we got to keep reminding them. And I don't have no problem with that, right? Understand, right? You feel me? When you're hearing certain information, know what is truth for you. Try to recognize what happens to you when you're hearing truth. Some people get the chills. Some people third eye start pulsating. Something might be going on with your heart. You feel me? Your hair might stand up. Understand, pay attention to what's going on when you're listening to this information so you can know what you truly resonate with, okay? It's a spiritual thing. Like, it's a feeling you get when you're hearing that truth, okay? When you're hearing that shit, you know it's the truth, right? Just recognize your discernment, okay? Recognize, okay, oh shit, I just heard some truth. What my body doing? Because your body, our body's constantly giving us signals, okay? That's why I'm saying we different things happen to different beings, okay? Right? That's why you got to recognize what's going on with you. I can't directly tell you what's going on with you. You feel me? I can just tell you what the fuck we going on with me when I hear truth. I feel like a lot of us get them chills and shit, especially the chills. Just pay attention, you feel me, when you hearing this truth, okay? Or when you hearing this information, right?
Thank you. In his diary, which was discovered by his son after his death, Admiral Byrd tells an extraordinary story.
Admiral Byrd heard there was an entrance to the center of the Earth through the South Pole. And he took planes into the South, under the South Pole. And when he did that, he discovered that as he flew over the pole, suddenly he's looking at things that shouldn't be there. I mean, it was temperate. His squadron flew under the Earth, into the Earth.
It turns into this lush and green area, and he can't even believe his eyes. But that's just the beginning of his extraordinary story. He tells how all of a sudden he starts to see a shimmering rainbow city that's made of crystal. His airplane is taken control of when he suddenly sees these flying disc-shaped objects around them that lead him to the ground. Whereupon he's escorted into a cavernous type of an area where he meets a being he refers to as the Master in his diary. The Master tells him that they're highly disappointed in what humans are doing with nuclear weapons, and how they've recently destroyed Hiroshima and Nagasaki, and they really are concerned about what is going on the surface of the planet. They tell Admiral Byrd that they hope that humanity will ultimately stop this.
For UFO researchers, this account from Admiral Byrd's diary is particularly significant due to the fact that the modern UFO era began right after World
War. I wish I knew your real name, your mom. It seems from your picture that you are a Caucasian. You are not the same species as my people. We are totally different people. And that's what I explained. If you go back to the beginning of this video, you can eat that high protein diet. My people can't. Your digestive system, your hydrochloric acid in your stomach, your chloroplastic melanin field, your eomelanin and pheomelanin, you don't have that. We have that. You see that? We go by way of photosynthesis, vitamin D3 conversion from the sun. We are totally different beings. Just like a parakeet eat fruits, and you got a vulture that eats roadkill, just like you got a gorilla that eat fruits, and then you got, you know, different type of primates that eat different things, just like you have a mountain lion that's in the cold, then you got a regular lion that's in the sub-Saharan deserts of Africa, and their diets are different, their skin is different, their melanin is different, their geogenetic is different, but they're still part of the same feline system. The birds are still part of the fowl kingdom. Well, I am a black man, you are a white man, even though we're a part of man, per se, if we want to even, because we can get scientifically in that too, but I'm not here to bash anybody. I'm here to just spit truth. Even though that you are called a human being and I am a human being, we are still two totally different species. See that? Which would mean in our geographical location is different. You will come from the mountains of Caucasus, high in the air. That's why your nose is long. That's why your nasals point towards the ground. That's why a lot of y'all are more expanding when it comes to the respiratory than ours, because y'all are used to breathing in air from the ground because y'all was up in the air. And that's the reason why y'all pigmentation is the color it is, because most of the time y'all was hidden away for thousands of years in a cave, which it makes your complex lose a lot of the fuel and the eumelanin that you got. You see that? Y'all stomachs have evolved and have basically culturized itself to eat all these proteins, because y'all was used to eating the rats and anything that y'all found inside of the cave. If you get books and start studying caveman history and studying the mountains of Caucasus and just really studying the history of the white man or of the Caucasian, you'll start seeing that y'all can eat certain things that the black man can't eat. You see what I'm saying? We from the islands, or we're from Africa, where we didn't lack zinc, we didn't lack copper, we didn't lack gold. You see that? That's why y'all have social problems like that. That's why y'all hunt the way y'all do. The reason why that hunting spirit is in y'all, because that's what y'all did when y'all was in the mountains. Y'all hunted for y'all food. Y'all hunted, or y'all stole food from each other. That's where you get the word snack food from. Snack food actually come from snatch food. You know, we didn't use forks and pen. Y'all built that type of stuff because y'all was trying to simulate animals. That's why y'all ran down and killed y'all preys. We didn't need to do that because we had bushes that grew berries. We had vines. We had grapes. We had watermelons. We had bananas. We had all types of different things that was grown by the sun for a sun people. So you can eat the proteins like that. And I'm gonna tell you the truth. A lot of Caucasians are now coming to me because the protein is now, you know, killing them too. So eventually, even though it's not messing with you now, eventually it's gonna catch up with you. Your mama, isolated. Eventually it's gonna catch up with you too. So y'all can eat beans and grains and all these gnarly chemistries and gnarly foods. Y'all can. But eventually it's gonna catch up with you as well. It might not be in this generation. It might even be 1,000 years from now, but potentially how y'all was made, y'all basically mutated, just like the man. If you look up the genetic codes, and I'm not talking about the Bible or spirituality, I'm just talking about the genetic code of human beings, man will look like a mutation of a woman. That's why we got nipples that milk don't come out of. That's why we got erected clitoris that they call penises. You see that? So we got a lot of structure functions that we can't even use on our bodies. But if you look at a woman, the woman can use them, showing that we're a mutation of the black woman. The black man is. Same thing when it comes to y'all. Y'all are more of a mutation due to like 7,000 to 70,000 years of the black man. I mean, I'm just keeping it real. When we talk about science, now y'all don't get on my throat because I'm speaking against religion and the Bible don't say this. I'm just talking about studying and what you can pull out of the ground and what archaeology can tell us and what you can see from straight from your eyes and reading this stuff. So it's certain stuff that you cannot, that we can't do, that you can do, that will not kill you or hurt you, but will harm the hell out of us. You know what I'm saying? Period. Point blank, period. And we prove this all the time, time and time again. And it shows you that, you know, all of the different DNA sequences that's inside of y'all. We got 9 series DNA. You have 6 series. If you check your DNA, you will see all different types of animalistic traits built up within y'all. And one of them is actually the monkey blood, a monkey DNA. You know, you'll find that inside of y'all DNA series. You won't find none of that inside of ours, showing that y'all are eukaryotic cells and we are prokaryotic cells. We come from prokaryotes. Y'all are eukaryotic. Y'all come already with the organisms or the organelles inside of y'all. We are prokaryotic cells that came with one organelle system that evolved into what we being now, because we don't come from Earth. Y'all come from the Earth. We come from the cosmos. We are literally classified by the government as extraterrestrial beings. Y'all, we are. So your food and your diet will be totally different from ours, and we need different food and fuel to actually fuel our bodies rather than you do. So you can eat chicken and red meat and stuff like that all day, but if my people do it, they're gonna be in a hospital with diabetes, high blood pressure, heart disease, and all of that. But essentially, y'all do, you know, come from us. So eventually it's going to catch up to your kind and your species too, if y'all don't hurry up and change these diets. And that's it. And I just hope I'm not, you know, hurting anybody's feelings here. This is not to mark my page or to try to get me blocked or nothing. I just got back on YouTube. I just like spitting truth, and I don't want to have to alter the truth just because I want to keep my page and my following. So I got to tell the truth.
Leaked footage of our flat Earth from the 1969 Apollo mission. Here you can see our local sun orbiting the ice barrier. If you adjust the settings, you can see the land beyond our ice wall, a dark, barren wasteland that has not been explored.
The Strange Truth That You Have Never Known, Part 3. This is why the genius scientist Nikola Tesla was so obsessed with the number 369. He once said, "If you can understand the mystery of the number 369, you will decode the universe." To understand this, we need to know that humans did not create mathematics, but rather discovered it because it is the operating rule of the universe. It is the language of the universe. Below is what Tesla discovered when doubling 1. We get 2, doubling 2, we get 4. Doubling 4 gives 8. Doubling 8 is 16, the sum of 16 is 7. Doubling 7 gives 14, and the sum of 14 is 5. Doubling 5 gives 10, and the sum of 10 we return to the number 1, and this pattern repeats infinitely without the appearance of the numbers 3, 6, 9. Interestingly, when doubling 3 we get 6. When doubling 6, we get 12, and the sum of 12 is 3. These two numbers are interrelated, and only 9 is the highest independent number. If 3 and 6 are negative and positive, then they are a higher entity controlling this universe. Tesla said that these three numbers in a higher dimension are controlling the three-dimensional world we live in.
Mm-hmm. That's another shit that cracked me up. White people say they don't believe in aliens till you ask them who built the pyramids. Aliens? Then ask them any other time. There's no such thing as aliens. Crazy. They just don't want to believe a black man designed something that they can't fuck with to this day. You understand me? Motherfucker, you know how we built the pyramids? You ever play in a sandbox? You gotta ask a simple question. Just always flip the script. What if up is down and down is up? What if you look down into space standing up on Earth? This is how we built the pyramids. You play in a sandbox. It's easy to move a mountain of sand into position. Once you wet sand, it holds its form like concrete. You put the first brick at the apex of this motherfucker, all right? You move sand out of this corner and that corner and place bricks there on both sides all the way to the top. Now you let the sand dry out and drop that brick right through that bitch. Sand under pressure when it's dry moves like fluid. That's why you always find viaducts in all of the motherfucking pyramids so the sand can shoot the fuck out the bitch. Now you have a hollow chasm. And it's built into the ground in the same specs. It's not really a pyramid, it's a diamond. It is now topped off by quartz, and at the bottom is topped off by quartz. When moonlight comes through, it refracts off of the quartz in the bottom, the first refracting laser, illuminating the night sky, which is why they called Pharaoh God, because he could turn night into day. Thus the all-seeing eye on your dollar bill above the pyramid. Because the only part of the human body made out of quartz is a human eye. When it dries out, it's small granules of quartz. That's why light transfers through it. Holla at your boy.
It's the gut. Now, we're going to get some gentian root. Write these down. We're going to get some gentian root. You see that? Very, very good for the gut. We're going to get some gravel root. Very good gut sweeper. We're going to get some slippery am inner bark. Very good to cleanse that gut. We're going to get some cascara sagrande. Very good to cleanse that gut. We're going to get some pavana. Very good to cleanse and to sweep that gut.